Hello friends, welcome. In this video we would learn how to make a good looking bar chart in PAR. Suppose when we want to submit a report and that contains some categorical variables like smoker, non-smoker, gender, male, female, or some another category like whether somebody belongs to a country or not. So when we have categorical variables, plotting bar chart could be a useful tool, and R provides a lot of good way to make your chart look better. You can do it in Excel as well, but since we need to learn everything, so friends, first of all, this is my data, serial number. I have 50 observations of lung capacity and their smoking habits, whether they smoke or not, or gender, male, female. So here two variables, smoking and gender. These two variables are categorical variables, and lung capacity is the ratio variable here, friends. So we will discuss here because bar chart can be made for categorical variables just to show the category of the variables. So this is the class of the my object data frame. The summary, I say this is summary. These two variables, smoking and gender, these are two categories like no, yes. 24, 26, female, 25, 25. So here we would make a bar plot of smoking. Okay, friends, smoking habits. So let's start the journey. So first of all, we need to learn a command table. The first command is table. What does table do? It makes a category-wise distribution and says how many observation belong to a certain category. So if I say it's like a table, frequency table, we can say directly. It say me no 24, yes 26. Like non-smokers are 24 and smokers are 26. Okay friends, then now we start making bar plot. The command for making bar plot is bar plot itself. Then we would put this table command inside the bracket, table smoke. Okay friends, in this way, bar plot table smoke. It will give us a graph like this. Let me maximize it. So this is our graph. But friends, if you see, this is in like actual numbers. Suppose you want to make it in percentage, then we have to do nothing. Divide this table by the number of observations. As I had already mentioned, we had 50 observations. So I am dividing it by the number of observation, 50. So you divide it by the observation you have in your data. Again, divide it. So now we have, you can see friends here, it's in percentages. Now, when we plot a graph in your report, you need some labels on it. Like what do you want to show on Y label? What do you want to show in X label? So on Y label, it's percentage. On X label, it's just smoking. So I'm just using, this was the command we had earlier here. Now just control C and control V here so far and put comma and add these two commands, Y lab for Y label, and put character commands in inverted commas, and then X lab for X label, put smoking, what you want, the good looking. So now we can see friends, here it's percentage, here it's smoking. Now you want to category, like here we are having no, yes. Suppose you want to mention here something else, non-smoker and smoker, like Salman Khan and Shah Rukh Khan. So in this way, like wherever you want to just categorize them by different name rather than the variables, yes, no. So here I say, it's the same command, we just control C from here. We need to add one more argument, that's all. This is the control C, control V, then names.org. This is the argument for the names, and just combine non-smokers and smokers. Okay, friends. So just run again it. I am doing nothing, just simply adding one more argument for names.org and run. So now we are having here non-smokers and smokers. Now we need a good title here. Like what is this? So what can we do? Again, same just control C, copy it here, and then add one more argument, main, M-A-I-N, and just mention any title. I am having here smoking habits, and then run it. So now we have this title here. So what is left now, friends? Color. So what can we do? Add colors to it. So how can we do the same arguments we have so far? Just copy and paste them and add one more argument here. Add one more argument, that is color. So I am having red, blue. These are my favorite colors. If you want else, just mention their names or their numbers as per our coding. Run. Aha, they look great. Now, here friends, we see these percentages. They are like, we need to rotate them. So they look like this. So we can do it by putting one more argument, LAS is equal to 1. So same, the entire command is same. We are adding one more argument in this way. Only this, LAS is equal to 1. But after adding this, we run again. Now they are rotated. Suppose like as we see in many reports, they are not in this way. They are horizontal like this and this way. So what to do? The same command so far, and then add one more argument, horizontal is equal to true. I am writing T only. You can use T-R-U-E, full true. But I use T for short, it saves a space, and then run it again. Smokers, non-smokers, percentage, because here I had changed the label name, friends. Now Y label has become X and X label has become Y. Percentage here on the horizontal axis, and smoking is on vertical axis. Now here if I see here smokers, non-smokers and smoking, it doesn't look good. So I am just removing this argument, LAS is equal to 1. I need to remove this argument. We don't need such kind of rotation. So simply run it again. After removing this, run. So now it looks pretty good. So in this way, friends, we can create a good bar plot in R. It's very easy and handy. And it's very useful when we want to make graphs in a loop manner. Like we want to make 10 or 50 graphs for some variables in a file, then it could be very helpful, because in Excel we need to repeat everything. But here it could be done very easily by making a simple loop. Thanks, friends. Keep watching.